My name is Merrill Dubrow, CEO of Mark Research and a 35-plus year veteran of the Insights community and the host of our podcast, On the Mark. Welcome to another Merrillism segment. Today's segment is sign or not to sign? That is the question. Okay, I must admit before I explain what that title means, I must say I'm a little down, perhaps depressed. Definitely not happy with what happened to my Dallas Mavericks last month. Yes, my Dallas Mavericks. Yes, I'm from Boston. Yes, I love the Boston Celtics. But being an MFFL, which is a Mavs fan for life, means something to me. And in fact, something very special. A shout out to Mark Cuban, who I've never met, Sint Marshall, who was a doll and I've met a bunch of times, and Ronnie Foss, for building an amazing and nice community and fan base. Okay, back to the title of today's podcast. Sign or not to sign Kyrie Irving. Yes, most people say Kyrie is an amazing talent, but off the court is a different thing and not worth the trouble. I get it. I understand what everybody's saying. And frankly, I don't deny it 100% at all. But on the court, this guy is special. On the court, what he does with the ball is amazing. And frankly, if the Mavs sign him, he'll be an MVP candidate in 2023 and 2024. Yes, I said it. If the Mavericks re-sign him, they will have a second MVP candidate in Kyrie Irving to Luka. I promise you that. For the simple reason, he will be a 40-50-90 guy. Something that has only happened maybe 20 times in the history of the NBA. So what that means is he will shoot 40% from threes, 50% field goal percentage, and 90% from the line. And he'll become only the fourth player to do it twice, which is unbelievable. He'll join Larry Bird, Kevin Durant, and Steve Nash, who have all done it multiple times. To me, and no, I don't pretend to be a GM. Nico Harrison has that job for the Mavs, not me. But to me, you do sign him for 4 years. He will be special with Luka. This team was and is not built for Luka, Kyrie in 22-23. However, they can do that moving forward. They need to draft a big man who can rebound and defend. They need to continue to space the floor with shooters, which they can. I promise you, Green and Hardy and Hardaway are special shooters, and two of the three are young and will get better. Yes, they have some pieces and bad contracts that just don't fit. But most teams do. I say, sign Kyrie to 4 years. Let him make Dallas his home. Draft the big man. Sign a free agent or two that fits in with Kyrie and Luka. Kyrie and Luka are pros. They will figure it out over the summer and in training camp. Commit yourself to playing team defense, and you will now have an offseason to work on that. And fix the foul shooting. 74% is just not good enough to win in many close games. I think they can and will do. I say sign Kyrie. It is the best chance you have to get where you want to go. What do you think? What do you say? My name is Merrill Dubrow. Thanks for listening to today's podcast. Sign or not to sign, that's the question. Stay well, stay safe, and please, please stay in touch.